Hey everyone, and welcome back to Open. So once again, we are hybrid, coming to you virtually from Charry Executive Suite. And our last guest is a Bronx native performance poet, event host, spoken word workshop specialist, and curator. Her content offers a nostalgic reflection of her upbringing, as well as an exploration of New Yorkian cultural identity and the vast emotional spectrum of a woman navigating her 20s. Joining us to share more, we welcome performance poet, Leah. Hello and welcome.
Hi. Well, thank you for having me.
Well, welcome. And so while I did give everybody a little background on all the hats that you're wearing, because performance poet was the first in your description, I introduced you as such. However, from what I'm understanding, you're doing a lot of producing now.
Yeah. Yes. I mean, I've been hosting shows. It kind of happened organically. Started off performing. Was blessed enough to find a community through that. That community welcomed me as resident poet, and eventually, I began hosting, trying to get involved a little on the back end, wanting to give back to those having the same experience that I had. And then I, I continued to pretty organically from hosting to producing shows myself so that I could hopefully run some things and have my own executive suite someday.
I like that. So let's just give everybody a little background as to how you got there, right? Because what we have written here is that you're assistant producer for Inspired Word, right? And I know before we got on air, you shared a little background on some productions that you're presenting that already passed as an expansion to Inspired Word. So let's just give everybody a little background on the trajectory.
Okay, so about Inspired Word NYC, just a couple sentences and then back to me. So Inspired Word NYC is it's an organization that has been producing open mics and featured shows for performers of all kinds from throughout New York City. And that's music, that's poetry, that's rap, that's, we've had minors, we've had interpretive dancers, we've had a lot of comedians. It's really just an open platform for artists to come in and share their work. And it started off as an open mic 12 years ago. It was founded by a renowned journalist named Michael Geffner. He's actually a sports journalist, ironically enough. And he's been doing it throughout New York City for a while. I kind of joined as a scared little new performing poet with her paper shaking in hands about 5 or 6 years ago. And then I loved it there. I loved the feeling, the environment, the culture. And Michael gives me a lot of tough love. He's a good mentor for me. And as I began hosting shows with him, he kept encouraging me to get started on putting on my own, and using his platform, not his platform, but our platform, which does have a large following that's already existent. I was able to start putting on a couple of shows throughout New York City. Now that I'm living in good old Bushwick, Brooklyn, we've been focusing on trying to find a community here. We've put on two shows in Brooklyn. We had our last this past Sunday at Crystal Lake in Williamsburg. That was a whole lot of fun.
That was great. That was a great background and leading up to where we are today, and that really invites the conversation of what that felt like to be in the presence of people physically, right? Because that's been a whole nother thing an experience. And although New York has reopened for quite some time now, I feel as if though now is when it sunk in.
Yeah. We started putting on shows with vaccine mandates about a year ago. I'd say a little over a year ago in person. The venues that we worked with were pretty strict on that, but now it feels, I would agree with that statement. It does feel like it's everybody kind of out and about, and it feels a little more safe and a little more free. for everybody coming out. It's been really thrilling. And we did the whole virtual show thing for a while. I actually still put on, we have a summer hiatus, but I still do put on a monthly virtual show with a good friend of mine that started in the pandemic. I know this is an example of one of those hybrids right there.
Right. This is the way we're living right now. And in all honesty, it is advantageous because you're reaching a broader audience. So it becomes this, you know, it becomes a question of like, okay, are we just going to embrace the fact that this is our new norm, or are we going to just switch over to just live presentations, right? And so where we're at right now, even us, like we're in studio, we're not in studio right now. And the truth is that this is just where we are. Mm-hmm. But there's something refreshing about it. There's something refreshing about just embracing the shift.
Yeah, it does feel like a kind of best of both worlds, I think, right now. I would be lying to you if I didn't say I didn't miss the network I had through my virtual shows. I remember in the first few months of the pandemic when we were all home, it was like we were getting artists from London and Malaysia. I remember we had two guys from India who would wake up at 5 a.m. the next day. So you were right. I mean, we do broaden the audience that way. But I like to think that hopefully we can continue to figure out a way just like this to keep it as the best of both worlds, and hopefully be able to reach out to those audience that we now know that we can reach out to that we weren't able to maybe in 2019, you know?
Yeah. And so just out of curiosity, how did they learn about it, right? Like, how did they even get linked up to this this virtual show?
So we were doing, Inspired Word was putting on a virtual show, and then I was putting on a virtual show separately with an organization called the Rose Garden Events. Both of those organizations use Eventbrite and hashtags very religiously. So it's just reaching out to the network we have. I think that those virtual shows started at a time when that's exactly what people were looking for. And so for many of those people, it stuck, not everybody, but for many of those people, it stuck. So I think it just kind of happened at a time where those artists, including myself, were looking for that type of community that we couldn't have physically.
Yeah, it's like cross culture, right? And yeah, unifying the world, because it's like a taste in different palettes, and so bringing us back to what you do, right? You're a performance poet, you're a producer, you're a host, and so, you know, how do you choose what role you're going to play, as well as the projects that you're going to mount and or host?
Well, that is still a juggling game I am learning to master. It is not at all perfected, but I will say that I do believe in my heart of hearts, my real passion lies in performing. That's where it started. And I think that's that in giving back to New York City Live Arts and providing a platform for other artists, it can only increase my own network. So selfishly, it having that community assists my own growth as an artist and my own following. And there's enough love to go around, you know, and that's the attitude that I've had to take. It doesn't have to be me against the other performers. It has to be, let's make a space for all of us and let's continue growing that space. So that's how I make my peace with the juggling act. But I do know when I have to step in and step out. I'd say that like my performance persona and my hosting persona are vastly different. Like you would almost not believe they're the same person on stage. Because when I'm hosting, I get to performing is so cathartic for me. It's deep and personal. And I have a lot of passion and sometimes even anger, but when I'm hosting, you know, I'm just trying to have a good time and keep things flowing. So I do think that those two personas coexist together, maybe even, dare I say, like a Jekyll and Hyde kind of thing. You can't have one without the other. that's how I manage that.
Well, I gotta say, just listening to you speak, it's really, I want to say, hopeful even to know that as I introduced you as a young lady navigating through her 20s, this is how you're communicating and your awareness, your level of awareness. So I'm really excited to share this with our viewers.
Thank you.
So before we go, do you have anywhere you're going to be performing?
Yes. So you can generally find me at the Parkside Lounge on Tuesdays. That's the Parkside Lounge in the Lower East Side. All of my information is on my website, on my Instagram. It's at Leah V Speaks on everything across the board. And I will be hosting and featuring at a very big show on August 6th at an off-Broadway theater in the Upper West Side called the Triad Theater. And so some flyers and promo should be going out for that soon. But usually you can find me on Tuesday at the Parkside Lounge and floating around other open mics in NYC.
All right, that's what's up. That's Leah V, everyone. And guess what? You're going to get a taste of her performance, because when we return, Leah V is going to perform for us after the break. So don't go anywhere.